Okay, so I'm Maisey Herring, and if you don't know who I am, I would really like to get to know you. So come and get to know me. I'm a very open and honest person, and I'm gonna be a senior. Well, I am a senior. Yeah, I am a senior. But today I'm gonna be talking about lukewarmness, which is something that has really convicted me, especially over quarantine and everything. And it just, we went from having such a busy schedule, everyone, and I hope I'm not the only one who has gone through this, and I hope some of y'all can relate, but we went such a busy schedule. You had your checklist of what you were doing for the day. You had where you were going. You had what you were doing. You knew it. Your schedule was down to a T. You were in the rhythm of things, and then everything stops. There's nothing, and you have so much free time. You don't know what to do with yourself. I know for me, my sleep schedule, I went from being up all day to being nocturnal and not going to sleep until like 4 or 5 in the morning and then sleeping all day. But I found it really hard during that time to really pick up my Bible and focus on God's word. And I thought I had mostly everything figured out with my Christianity, and I knew where I was going, and I knew what was happening, and I had everything figured out. And over quarantine, and it wasn't really until the end when I was starting to get back into things that I was pretty lukewarm. It was hard for me to pick up my Bible and actually read out of it and to search through it to find what I need when I'm not being told to do that or being held accountable for it, and I'm just sitting in a room by myself, not really knowing what to do. And I don't know if anyone else struggled with that, but I know that was a huge struggle, and I talked to a few friends I had, and they were like, yeah, it was really hard to actually open up my Bible and see what was going on and see where I needed to work, because you're in a room, or at least I was in a room by myself most of the time, just sitting there, silence, nothing going on around me. And that's the perfect time to just dive into God's word and listen to what he's telling you and open up your Bible and read. And if you have no idea what you're gonna read, just start with a book and go through it. And I think that is what I had to learn how to do through this. But also I found myself doubting God, which is not something I'm very proud of myself for doing, but I found myself looking for other outlets and being sad about all these events changing and my schedule going down and my friends not getting their senior year and how is it going to affect my senior year. Just kind of selfish thoughts, but also thoughts that of doubt. And I didn't really, I know God has a plan, but I didn't have that faith in that moment in time, which was really upsetting. And I know I'm not the only one who struggled with that, because we had so many events, so many things lined up to do. We had summer, we had school, end of the school year, so exciting. And then nothing. It all gets canceled. I know we at church had church camps and events planned for the summer. I'm sure you had trips planned for the summer, and everything's gone, wiped out. And you just had to take a step back and realize that you're not in control. You will never be in control. And I think that putting your faith in God, or at least for me, being able to wholeheartedly put my faith in God was something I had to relearn how to do because I had forgotten. You know, when you're a new believer, it's all exciting and it's joyous and everything's brand new, your life has changed, and then you get into a routine of things and you kind of fall out of that. And it's just another check off the box. It's like as if it were summertime. Say you're sweating, it's so bad, you do not know what to do, you're drenched in sweat and you hop into a pool of lukewarm water. Yeah, it'll be a little bit cooling, but it's not gonna do much for you as much as a cold glass of water or jumping into a cool pool would be, because you're still gonna be hot in that lukewarm water. Or if you're freezing and you're turning blue or whatever, and you see a hot tub and then you get in it and it's lukewarm, you're still cold. Nothing has changed. You're still freezing. But imagine how different it would be if you were to jump into that hot tub and it were to be hot and warm and cozy and you feel safe and you feel happy. And I think that's something that a lot of people struggle with, is we get into the routine of things and we get into just being lukewarm and not knowing, not really being on fire for God anymore. And I know for some people, in my personal experience, is I've had family that has been turned away from God just for the pure fact of lukewarm Christians. And that breaks my heart, because I want people to know Jesus and to know his love and to know who he is. And in 2 Timothy 3:5, it says, having the appearance of godliness, but denying the power, it says to avoid such people, because they're gonna turn you away. They may look godly, but their actions are different. You may have a solid group of friends, and they may be great, and you may have had them for so long, but are they helping you in your relationship with God? Are they moving you forward? Are you on fire for God? Or are you just sitting back and watching and listening and not really doing the works of Christ? Are you walking with the Holy Spirit? Or are you watching to see what the Holy Spirit will do for you? I think that's something that we have to not just be listeners of God, but to really go in with God and be wholeheartedly with God and not be lukewarm, because being lukewarm is so dangerous for our faith. And I think pure joy and pure love for God comes with being wholeheartedly and in there for God 100%. So I'm gonna leave you with Revelation 3:16, which says, so because you were lukewarm and neither hot nor cold, I spit you out of my mouth. I don't know about y'all, I do not want to be spit out of the mouth of God. I want to be with God, standing right next to him, feeling his joy in his presence. And I don't want to be lukewarm. And if you have a problem with that, contact me. I'll send you some videos. I'll talk to you about it. If you need a partner to help you be accountable of reading your Bible, or if you want to meet up to read a Bible any day of the week, I'll be there. Call me. I will drop anything and everything, and I will be there. I just think we need to learn how to be on fire for God and not be lukewarm water that's disgusting and we don't want to be there. So that's all I have to say. And if you do want to contact me, ask Jake or Cecily or someone, get my information. It doesn't matter. I do not care if you text me or anything. If you call me, if you FaceTime me, do whatever you want. I'll be there for you.